choking on a number and digging on the radio. Well, I just crossed the San Benito County line when I heard that highway start to whine, and I knew that left rear tire was about to blow. Well, the spare was flat and I got up tight, cause it wasn't a filling station in sight, so I just limped on down the shoulder on the rim. I went as far as I could, and when I stopped the car, just right in front of this little bar, kind of a redneck looking joint called the Fond Lake Inn. Well, I stuck my hair up under my hat and told the bartender I had a flat, but he'd be kind enough to give me change for a one. Well, there's one thing I was sure proud to see. Wasn't a soul in the place but him and me, and he just looked disgusted and pointed toward the telephone. Well, I called the station down the road a ways, and he said he wasn't very busy today, and he could have someone there in about 10 minutes or so. Well, I ordered a beer and sat down at the bar when this fellow walked in and said, "Who owns this car with the peace sign, some mag wheels, and four on the floor?" He looked at me and I damn near died, and thought I'd go ahead and wait outside, laid a dollar on the bar and headed for the door. Well, just when I thought I'd get out with my skin, these five big dudes come strolling in with this one old drunk chick and some fellow with green teeth. I was almost to the door when the biggest one said, "You tip your hat to this lady, son," and when I did, all that hair fell out from underneath. Now the last thing I wanted was to get in a fight at the Fond Lake Ranch on a Saturday night, especially when there's five of them and only one of me. Well, they started in a laughing, I got kinda sick, knew I better think of something pretty quick, so I just reached out and kicked old Green right in the knee. Now he let out a yell that curled your hair, and before he could move I grabbed me a chair and said, "Watch him, boys, he's a fairly dangerous man." Said, "You may not know it, but this man's a spy. He's an undercover agent for the FBI, and he's been sent out here to infiltrate the Ku Klux Klan." Well, he was still bent over, holding onto his knee, and everyone was looking and listening to me, so I just laid it on thicker and heavier as I went. I said, "Would you believe that he has gone so far as tearing Palin stickers off of bumpers of cars, and he voted for Obama for president? Now, he's a friend of them long-haired hippie-type pinko fags, and I'll bet you he's even got a commie flag tacked up on the wall inside of his garage. Now, he's a snake in the grass, I tell you guys. He may look dumb, but that's just a disguise. He's a mastermind in the ways of espionage." Well, they started looking real suspicious at him, and he said, "Now, you just wait a minute, Jim. You know he's lying. I've been living here all of my life. I'm a faithful follower of Brother John Birch. He belonged to the Avenel Baptist Church, and I ain't even got a garage. You can call him and ask my wife." Well, he started saying something about the way I was dressed, but I didn't stick around to hear the rest. I was too busy moving and hoping I didn't run out of luck. But when I hit the door, I was making tracks. They just took my car down off of the jacks. I threw the man a 20 and jumped in and fired her up. Mario Andretti just sure being proud of the way I was moving when I passed that crowd coming out the door and headed towards me at a trot. Well, I guess I should have gone ahead and run, but somehow I couldn't resist the fun of chasing them all just once around the parking lot. Well, I headed for the car, but I hit the gas, turned around and headed them off at the pass. I was slinging gravel and putting a ton of dust in the air. Yeah, I had them all out there stepping and fetching like their head was on fire and their asses were catching. I thought I better go ahead and leave before the cops got there. But when I hit the road, I was really wheeling. I had gravel flying and rubber squealing, and I didn't slow down till I was almost a Trace Venus. Well, next year I think I'll reroute my trip. I wonder if anybody would think I flipped if I went to Fond Lake via Coalinga. It's a take.
They ain't gonna put me in the movie.
ain't gonna make a big star out of me. Ain't far, not a man that's sad and lonely. All I gotta do is act naturally. Well, I'll bet you I'm gonna be a big star. Might win an Oscar, you can't never tell. Movies gonna make me a big star. Cause I can play the part so doggone well. Well, I and I know that you will plainly see the biggest fool that ever hit the big time. And all I gotta do is act naturally. I said now all I gotta do is act naturally.
Let's try it again.
I said now all I gotta do is act naturally.
That's the undercut your cover agent from the FBI right there. I saw it.
Son of a bitch, I think we've got a chase on our hands.
Come here, dog. Come here. Ruby.
Son of a bitch, there they are. That's a mean looking dude, mean looking dude. I hope he gets it. He's had it now.
License and registration.
But ain't again.
Have a good day, sir.
Thank you, officer. Thank you so much.
There's fine looking people. Sheriff. I do too. Trouble at Fawn Lake Ranch. And here it comes. Uh-oh. Pat Garrett.
I don't know what to tell you, officer, but maybe this will help a little bit. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.
Our law at work.